And again, service is the only one where we're lacking. So we have a good chance. Oh, it's service. Oh, unfortunate, unfortunate. The solo opponent gets another VP card. We don't. We get nothing. And that's that. Wow. That's a shame. Okay. Oh, and we have to discard one of these. If anything, I think we would get more of those guys. So I'm going to get rid of this. I mean, this is worth 3 points right now, but yeah, we're going to get rid of that one. Okay, let's rotate. What are we doing now? What are we doing now? We really want to do this before this game is over. And if we're going to do that, we need more guests. We also have this problem. I mean, we can't play all these guys because they all need a valet and we only have one. Now, we could get a bunch of money with this guy, right? We can play him. Yeah, see, this needs 4 gentlemen to play. I don't have 4 gentlemen in my hand. And even if I did, I couldn't play all these guys. I do like the idea of playing this guy, though. Who else could we play? We could play her. We could play her, or we pick up. That would be the other thing we could do. We could pass. I mean, I'd have to spin reputation to get this guy over here to play this guy. So if we wait, we could hire. Okay, we could do that main gazebo there. That would give us 1 guest. Well, and then they each give a guest, so it'd be, we get 3 into our hand. But we still couldn't play all these guys. We do want to get 1 more, because he's going to 3. So we do want 1 more estate. Maybe the fenced paddock? We're in a bit of a bind here. I feel like this is a priority. And in order to get that, I have to both, I think, I need to pass. Okay, we're going to pass. I didn't want to do this, but I think I'm in a little bit of a bind. I'll just get the money. And with 400, I could get the billiard room. I don't know. Now I'm gonna hold on to my money and just in case something good comes along. Okay, yeah, I believe here to use that, and I just forgot to move it off. Sorry if I got that wrong. Ooh, a 5. No monuments, so position 2. Now we're on to a national holiday. What that means is we can ignore the reputation restrictions. So we could play any tile and any guest that we wanted. That lets you play maybe a sort of a high-level card if you have a low reputation. This would be your one chance to do so. Now, we're at reputation 6, so we don't have to worry about that. It really doesn't help us. We either want to get this fly fishing going, or this ball in the Great Hall. And that's really what I want to try to make happen. And we also have a couple of pretty big guests that could attend. And we need 6 if we're going to do this. We got those 2. We could have 1 more lady, but no more of these gentlemen that need the valet, which is a lot of them. Okay, so we could also have her. And we would like to get this. We want at least 2 more reputation so that we can max that out. And that would be great for that. We'll be getting so much money. And look at this. We can play her because, again, that admirer bonus, we do have a prestige male there. So that would do it. Okay. That's not bad. Let's go. I think we're doing this. I think we're gonna make this happen. That guy's just money. Ooh, she's great. More reputation. Actually, that's too much reputation, isn't it? We don't need any more reputation. I guess money? Okay. More money? We might want to hold on to our gentleman if we want to do this. We'll need 4 gentlemen, so we might actually want to hold on to these guys. Maybe play her. Yeah, we'll play her as well. Okay, we'll stick with this. We'll stick with this. This has gotten a little complicated. We use our butler, valet, maid, and housekeeper. Now, first things first is money. We're getting a lot of it. 11. Okay. Oh, we're also getting a victory point card. Let's grab that. So that symbol there, let's consult our little handy dandy sheet here. That says, search the discard pile for any guest or family member and place into your active hand. Ooh. Not sure I want to give up 5 points for that. Okay, we're now getting a bunch of reputation. Well more than we need. And so I think we want to spend some of it on a refresh. Okay, yeah, we're going to spend 1, 2, 3, 4 on a refresh of this market. We're hoping for a monument to come out, frankly, because we have so much money, we could definitely afford it. Oh, yes, and one did come out. These ones get over here. And so, hold on, we gotta draw two more. So it's gonna be like that. There we go. Okay, and now we're going, so we did that special action, and now we're gonna enjoy our 5 reputation favor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're one away now from maxing out. That should be fine. We're getting some guests. A lot of casual guests. So we're getting 2 casual guests. Oh no, a negative guy. And another negative. Oh no. That's not good. So those are going into our hand. And then we have her. I think we want to use her ability to get rid of one of these. Let's get rid of this -4 points. Wow, that was awful. So we'll use her ability. This is ability to trash one of your guests, and this is why you might want to do that, because sometimes you get some bad casual guests. So that'll go back to the bottom. Those were our favors. So all of these are exhausted. All these in the discard pile. The Great Hall. Look at that. Worth 6 points, and now, wow. Could hold a Rager. The Grand Ball, that would be amazing. Not gonna happen, but would be amazing. And now, we have $1,500. And we could get this monument. 10 points. Not exactly where we want that. We were kind of hoping that that would be a service. I say, let's just grab that monument and, I don't know, just be happy. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. I think that's nice. Rolls a 5. Oh, wait, we got to fill this up first. So on a 5, getting position 2. Okay, last round before the final courtship. These are going to slide over, and we now have a monument. We get to move over, and I don't even have the token out. Max. We have maxed out our reputation. Whew, so what do we want to do on this last turn? We're ahead here in essentials. Again, service, not great. We're now ahead in estate. We're ahead in prestige. And we're ahead in sporting. We're ahead in everything but service. Now, unfortunately, service is one of the criteria. I have a handful of gentlemen. Look at this. Look at these gentlemen. I don't even know if you can... I can't even fit. I just have all dudes. All dudes. Problem is, 3 of them don't require anybody. These 2 need the green guy. Well, I can't think of anything great to do here. Tell you what. We're going to keep it nice and simple. We're just going to do that again. And we'll just play those two guys will get 600 bucks. Yeah, I think we'll just get this for 5. Okay, that's it. Not a great last turn there. But what are you gonna do? Oh no, a monument came out. Shoot. Don't you dare. 8. Oh, wow. Okay, position 1. Close to taking the monument. I don't think this matters because it's all over. Okay, well, it comes down to this, the final courtship. We're gonna add up everything. So let's see what the final theme is. Wow, sporting again. So 2 sportings. We're gonna count sporting twice, prestige, and then service. We're gonna add that all up together and see who has the most points. For us, it's gonna be 5, 6, 7. So we'll double that, 14. 23, 29, 29, that's it, because 0 in service. And let's see, 10, 18, 22. We won the final courtship, so we get another VP card. We also get one of the Fairchilds into our deck. That's going to be worth 8 points. Is really good. We have to discard one of these, so obviously it's going to be that one. We're left with our 3 final objectives, and there we go. Now we just have to score it up. Time to calculate our scores. Now our solo opponent, the Fitzherbert family, is very easy to calculate. We take their base number there of 99, and we add these secret VP cards that they've collected. Okay, so they're at 107. And now there's an optional scoring that I like to play with where they also get the points of any monument tiles that they've been able to collect throughout the game. So I believe they got 1. Yep, just 1. That'll be an additional 6 points. So they end with 113. So that's our target number. I definitely did something that I've never done before in this game. I didn't hire a single extra servant at all. You know, I never went to the butler's room. You get to hire 2 more servants, and never even bought a service building, mostly because they didn't come out early in the game. But I'm not sure how it worked out. I think we did pretty well, all things considered, but let's just calculate it out and see what happens. So the first thing we check is the VP for all of our improvement tiles. 46. Wow, so that's much better than I usually do. Getting this monument plus flipping the Great Hall and flipping the music room. I mean, that's 22 right there. So that's really good. Second thing we add up is all of our gentry cards. 23, 29, 32. So that's a subtotal right there of 78. That's pretty good. I think that's a little higher than I normally do. Now we're going to check our objective cards. We did max out, so that's 7 points. We have 4 prestige buildings and 3 sporting buildings. So that's 14 points altogether. Then we check our reputation VP. And for that, we look in the rule book. If you max out your reputation, it's 28 points. That subtotal there, 42. Okay, we get 2 points per servant. That's just 10. And we get a victory point for every 2 money. 2 extra points there. And these courtship cards. Looks like we'd never played them, so we get the full points, 17. Wow, and there you go. When I add all that up, 149. That's by far the highest score that I've been able to achieve in the solo game. Hopefully I didn't do anything wrong there. Well, there you go, guys. That's it. That is a complete solo playthrough of Obsession. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.